Welcome to the Juniper Threat Labs Attack Demo Series. For this demo, we will be talking about Rhysida Ransomware. This video will demonstrate how this ransomware group works. Afterwards, we'll show you how Juniper Network's customers can be protected. In May 2023, Malware Hunter Team tweeted about a new ransomware gang named Rhysida. At that time, the gang does not claim any infected organization. However, shortly thereafter, Rhysida Ransomware Gang claimed to have infected the Caribbean island of Martinique. In a notice, the council that runs Martinique said, "A cyber attack heavily disrupted the activities of the community and directly impacted users and partners. This incident marked the initial episode of several organizations that Rhysida claimed to have infected. Not long after that, they claimed to have infected a school in Illinois and then the Chilean army. Subsequently, they targeted additional institutions, including universities, hospitals, healthcare organizations, and even government entities. One of their latest hacks involves the claim of infecting Insomniac Games. They have issued a threat to leak 1.67 terabytes of data unless Insomniac Games complies with their ransom demand. Usually, when ransomware groups breach systems, they employ a tactic known as double extortion. This involves demanding a ransom payment to decrypt victim data, coupled with a threat to release or auction the stolen data unless the ransom is paid. Typically, they create a leak site hosted on Tor networks, using Tor for anonymity, making it challenging to trace the origin of the traffic. On their leak site, they publish a list of organizations they claim to have infected, and currently, the claim extends to 71 organizations. Furthermore, they post samples of stolen data as a proof of their successful hack. Their most recent claim, at the time this video is created, involves a university. The university is issued an ultimatum, which in this case is less than 6 days left, to pay a ransom of 8 bitcoins. For those willing to comply, they provide convenient links to Coinbase and Binance, facilitating the purchase of the required bitcoins. At the current exchange rate, with one bitcoin valued at $42,908, the ransom demanded from the university totals $343,264. These recent attacks prompted both CISA and the FBI to issue advisories on Rhysida ransomware. In CISA's Stop Ransomware Cybersecurity Advisory, they highlighted that Rhysida ransomware is known for targeting various sectors opportunistically, including education, healthcare, manufacturing, information technology, and government. The advisory also provides technical insights, such as Rhysida's initial access methods, specifically its utilization of remote services like VPNs to access networks. Additionally, they exploit vulnerabilities like zero logon to elevate privileges and engage in phishing attacks. Once inside a network, Rhysida employs living off the land techniques to navigate and conduct its operations. Among the tools in their arsenal are PowerShell, PSExec, RDP, PuTTY, PortStarter, Secrets Dump, NTDS Util, AnyDesk, Windows Event Utility Tool, and PowerView. Notably, the ransomware appends a .rhysida extension to all the files it encrypts. Now, let's walk through how the ransomware infection works. In this demonstration, we'll be using Kali Linux to host our malware. Using PowerShell, we'll download and execute the ransomware on our target system running Windows. Once the command is executed, we'll launch a process monitor to gain visibility into what is happening in the background. As observed, PowerShell.exe instantiates, and within a few seconds, it spawns a new process named Rhysida.exe. Notably, Rhysida.exe is running with high CPU usage as it has started encrypting files on the system. Specifically, files within the Python folder have already been encrypted and now appended with .rhysida extension. The ransomware has also dropped a PDF file, critical breach detected.pdf, serving as the ransom note. Upon opening the PDF file, it reveals the secret key necessary for inputting on their leak site. Once it completes encrypting all files, the ransomware modifies the desktop screen to display the ransom note. Visibly, our desktop files are encrypted, and opening them shows that they contain gibberish data. Let's now look and see whether or not this attack works as successfully with a Juniper SRX firewall enhanced with protection from Juniper's cloud-based advanced anti-malware solution, Juniper ATP. For the demo, Juniper Threat Labs is using the following setup. We have a VSRX pictured in the center. The VSRX is a virtual SRX firewall, providing network security protection. Its purpose is to inspect network traffic and to detect malware with the assistance of Juniper ATP Cloud. In addition to the virtual firewall and cloud-based protections, we are using Juniper Security Director, which is a centralized management system. It is used to facilitate our configuring and monitoring of the VSRX firewall. And we are using Juniper's Policy Enforcer as well. Policy Enforcer is a user intent-based tool that automates threat management policy updates and distribution across Juniper and third-party network devices. It helps automate threat remediation and micro-segmentation of policies across the network. We also have several Windows workstations, each of which is connected to the VSRX. Finally, we have an Ubuntu server acting as the malware download server where we host our ransomware. Before we proceed and attempt to simulate this attack with Juniper Connected Security solutions in place providing protection, let's first take a look at the threat prevention policy that we have set up on our security director and applied to the VSRX. To access the policy, we'll navigate to the Configure tab, and then we select Threat Prevention and Policies. As you can see, we already have an existing policy in place. Let's further inspect the protections being enforced by the applied policy. For this demo, our policies are configured to block command and control traffic at threat level 8 and above. We've also set it up to block infected hosts at threat level 8 and above. Additionally, we've configured our policy to use ATP Cloud for malware detection. And as you can see, we've elected to scan HTTP downloads and block threats at level 7 and above. This threat prevention policy, implied to the VSRX firewall, is a critical component of our defenses, protecting our systems against malware-related attacks. It allows us to detect and block malicious traffic as well as the activity of potentially infected hosts, which will then prevent the spread of malware throughout our network in the event that one of our systems gets compromised. With that, let's proceed with the attack using Juniper Connected Security. To get started, we'll connect to our target system and open the command prompt where we will execute the PowerShell attack. We will also open Wireshark to have a visibility of the network traffic. After launching our attack, we look at HTTP downloads from Wireshark. Notice that there is a GET request for Rhysida.exe. However, further inspection of the TCP stream reveals that the request returned. This request has been blocked due to possible malware detection. We can verify that by navigating the download directory. And we can see that we cannot execute the file Rhysida.exe as it is not a valid executable file. This shows that the SRX was able to successfully block the malware. We can verify this in the security director by navigating to Monitor, Threat Prevention, and HTTP File Download. Here, the file Rhysida.exe is flagged with a threat level of 10. According to our policy we configured earlier, threats with threat level 7 and above will be blocked. We can find more details about this file when we clicked on it, such as the URL and the host where this malicious activity was detected. We can also see more information such as behavior analysis. Network activity and behavior details, as well as the MITRE attack matrix. It's crucial to emphasize that Juniper ATP determines the threat level of a file through machine learning utilizing the gathered information. This means it doesn't rely on specific signatures, providing a dynamic and adaptive approach to identifying potential threats. Note that while the attack was unsuccessful, recall that the security policy being enforced on the VSRX locks host network activity when it detects threats at level 8 and above. When we clicked on ATP Cloud Hosts, we can see that the IP10.0.1.40 is flagged at threat level 9. This threat level score is determined by multiple factors such as malicious activities by that host, including malware downloads and command and control connections. This host then is now included in the infected hosts feed. What this means is that this host is now isolated and disconnected from the network temporarily. As it shows here, we do not have internet connection as we visit a couple of websites. Clicking at this host provides us with more details on why it is blocked, which in this case, the host attempted to download a malicious files with threat level 10. Once the admin is sure that the host or server is indeed free from infection, she can first select the host, and then under the investigation status section, she can select resolved fixed, which changes the status of this host to clean, and exclude this host from the infected hosts feed. After a few moments, this host will be connected back to the network again. We can verify that on the host by browsing the net. That completes our demo of Rhysida Ransomware. Check out more videos from the Juniper Threat Labs attack demo series by visiting juniper.net. Thanks for watching.